Hey everyone, this is Allie and welcome to the Common Room Chat, a brand new weekly video series keeping you updated on all the magical happenings in the wizarding world. So we have been so excited to bring you this brand new series of Harry Potter news, and I feel like the first week of January was the perfect time to start this, because last week was a very big week for the Harry Potter community. I think the one thing that everyone was most excited about was the 20th anniversary reunion special, Return to Hogwarts. I don't know about everyone else, but the reunion special aired at 4 a.m. on HBO Max, where I live, and that was a little early, but I did make sure to get up kind of early, and I dragged Chris out of bed, made him get the puppies, get everything ready, put my new Harry Potter hoodie on, and got ready to watch that show as soon as I woke up. I didn't know what to expect. Like, I knew that it would be a reunion. I knew that a few of the actors would be there talking to each other. But, like, as soon as the show started, Chris just looks over at me and goes, "Why are you crying?" And I honestly don't know why I was crying, but I was so emotional the moment it turned on. Like, I loved the little intro part where Robbie Coltrane and Matthew Lewis and Emma Watson all kind of received their Hogwarts letter asking them to come back. It was just so nostalgic because, you know, we see that in the first book. And yeah, I got very emotional, but it was a really good start to the show. I think they did a really great job breaking the reunion special into these different parts. They kind of went from the first book and they moved through talking to all of the actors and the directors, and they really showed everybody growing up through each book, you know, in order of the books and the movies. It all started, of course, with Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone, and it was so nice seeing all of the kids, you know, as kids. I love how they went into each director and how they worked with them, and the fact that Chris Columbus, they said that he really treated them like his children, and all of the actors, like all of the little kids who were just starting out, were talking about how they were little kids and it was hard for them to probably work with them because they just couldn't keep focused on what they were doing. And I think it's really cute to kind of see what it's like for children on a film set like that. And just seeing all of these actors that we've grown up with and we know them now as adults, beginning to see them again as kids and the way that they acted towards each other. I thought it was a really great start of the whole actual reunion, getting into the stories. And it was really nice to just kind of see all of them from the beginning. Then from that point, we continue to go through the different movies and the different directors that came into the picture at the time. And I really liked whenever we get into the third movie, because that's the first change in director. And we get to see a lot of, I guess, different views from the kids. You know, they're growing up a little bit. And one of the things that they talked about was how in the first couple movies, they had no idea the significance of the other actors that they were working with, you know, like Richard Harris and Alan Rickman. They just didn't understand the incredibleness of those actors. But then they get into the third movie, and I think my favorite part was Dan and Emma talking about how Dan was telling them, you know, you have to be cool. Gary Oldman's coming, because we all love Sirius. We all love Gary Oldman. And I can only imagine being these little kids who are about to meet him and being like, oh my goodness, I have to act cool. So I think that was really, really cute. Maybe I'm just a big fan of that part because I love Gary Oldman. But we also at that time get to see kind of the reasoning why they chose certain directors for certain movies. And you can see, you know, they're thinking about the book as a whole. They're thinking about the feeling and the vibes of each book. And they're looking for directors who have that kind of style, who can bring that to life. And you see that in the third movie, whenever they're talking about the director. You see the same thing kind of going up into the fourth movie, because they're talking about how, you know, it's going from Christopher Columbus, you know, it was all the magic and nostalgia and really bringing Hogwarts to life. But then the stories start getting a little darker. The kids start going through different experiences and maturing, and they needed to find, you know, people with that specific view, especially into like the fourth and fifth movies. So it's just a part. I don't know if I just wasn't expecting it or if it's something that I've never really delved into myself, but I enjoyed seeing the different views and reasoning in the director's choices. And just how lovely all of them seemed to be. All of the actors were talking about how they loved each director and the reason why. And of course, you know, you can't help but love a director story whenever the Weasley twins break one of their ribs. So it was pretty fun to see all of that kind of unfold as well. So you guys know me well enough to know that Hagrid is my absolute favorite character. And I've already seen a few people posting on, you know, Instagram and Facebook about the part in this reunion with Robbie Coltrane. Besides the fact that Robbie Coltrane, I feel like I just want to give him the biggest hug all the time, but he has this amazing part in the reunion where he talks about the story of Harry Potter living on and how Robbie Coltrane might not be here in 50 years, but Hagrid still will be. And he is like tearing up. And if you thought I was crying hard at the beginning of it, Hagrid breaking down and talking about the magic of Harry Potter got me. Like, that part is so emotional, and so many other people are feeling that as well. It has to be one of my favorite parts of the whole show. There are so many more emotional parts of this special, though, that I feel like I was probably crying a lot, and there were a lot of other people that were probably crying a lot, because there's this whole section where they go over in memory of all of the actors who have passed away, and I know we all have very special spots for most of them. You know, Alan Rickman, Richard Harris. It was very nice of them to include them in the special and, you know, go over each of them because they are a core part of the Harry Potter community. We all love the magic that they brought to the screen. And so, again, that part, a little emotional. But it wasn't just all emotional. There were a few really funny parts that I really enjoyed. Helena Bonham Carter, of course, Bellatrix, and she's just amazing and insane. She had a few really funny parts in the reunion. I really enjoyed her actually putting on Bellatrix's teeth whenever her and Dan were talking. Apparently, they had not been like washed or anything done before she put them on, but they like brought her right back into character and they were just having a really great moment and I enjoyed that. But I think my favorite part about her in the series was there was this whole little section where her and Gary Oldman were together. And of course, we all know Bellatrix kills Sirius. And Gary Oldman was like, "You killed me." And I just loved the whole interaction there. I love seeing those two together because they don't have a lot of time that they spend together in the films. Just, you know, the whole duel where Bellatrix kills him. But that was a really fun thing to see. Really anything with Gary Oldman in it, I was having a real good time watching him because there's just something about him. He's just very magical and brings such a great presence to it. So you guys can't tell. I really, really enjoyed the reunion special. Again, I didn't know exactly what to expect coming into it, but I've already watched it twice. I watched it and then as I was getting ready for the day, I just had it in the background so that I could listen to it again because I thought it was amazing. And of course, spoiler alert for the very end of it. It's really been a spoiler alert for the whole thing. But I knew that it was getting time for the show to end. And it showed the part with Alan Rickman, or Snape, casting his Patronus. We all know I'm not the biggest Snape fan. But he was casting his Patronus and I looked at Chris and I said, "Are they going to end this on Always?" And they do end it on Always. It's the last thing that they say. It got me too. And I don't even like Snape, but the Always got me. If you haven't seen the whole thing, I definitely recommend going out there. Just make yourself some hot chocolate, get all bundled up in your blanket, and just watch the whole thing from start to finish because it's so magical. And just looking at everybody else's reactions that I have seen from the Harry Potter community, it's very emotional and it's definitely going to get you at your core if you are a Harry Potter lover. So again, I definitely recommend watching it. It was fantastic. But the Harry Potter reunion special was not the only thing happening in the Wizarding World this week. I know a lot of the Harry Potter community like to open and watch videos on subscription boxes, so I thought I would give you guys an update on the happenings of subscription boxes from this week. So first on the list, happy renewal week to Litjoy Crate subscribers. January 1st was the renewal day for anyone subscribed to the Magical Subscription Box, and they are also having add-on week this upcoming week from January 4th to January 10th. So if you are subscribed, make sure if there's any add-ons that you would like to add to your box that you're getting on this week and getting them added into your account. And big Wizarding Trunk news this week, the Keep Collecting box is finally shipping out. I know myself personally, and I saw so many of you guys putting your emails out on Instagram that we got our email saying that our snowy owl, Reese, I know mine was Reese, I feel like everybody's was maybe Reese, but we got the email saying that it is on its way. So I should be getting this box this week. Keep an eye out if you didn't get a chance to get the box yourself, because I might have a giveaway on that video. And then for our last bit of subscription box news, I did want to give you guys an update on Cauldron Crate. Now, just to let you know, Cauldron Crate's shop is closed right now until January 10th. But the piece of news that I want to go over is an update that Leanne, the creator and curator of Cauldron Crate, put on her Instagram and Facebook page last week. So she did give us an update, pretty much letting us know that I know that she's going through medical school, and that she had had some people showing concern that she was just overworking herself. And so she gave us an update letting us know that she's not exactly sure how she is going to move forward with Cauldron Crate. She doesn't know if she is going to keep doing boxes, if she is going to keep just making items to put on her shop, or which direction she's really going. Now, of course, the subscription box lover in my heart really hopes that she continues doing subscription boxes. We are about to get the third out of the Horcrux series box, and I will be very, very sad if I don't get all seven of those, just because it's such a great idea for a subscription box, and I would love to have all of the collectible items from them. But I wanted to let you guys know that right now, the future of Cauldron Crate is looking a little fuzzy. And in case Leanne is watching this video, I do want to let you know that I hope you make the best choice for yourself. We all love your boxes and your items because you're just amazing at thinking of original ideas and bringing them into existence. But I can only imagine how hard it is going through medical school at the same time as trying to run your own small business. So definitely do what's best for you, and I can't wait to see what the future holds. Now, before I end our subscription box segment, I do want to let you guys know that I am currently subscribed to The Wizarding Trunk, Cauldron Crate, Geek Gear, and Litjoy Crate. Now, if you guys have any boxes, any other boxes that you think are boxes worth subscribing to, let me know, because I'm always looking for subscription boxes to add to my subscription box problem. And I would also love to know which boxes you would like to get news on. Now, moving on to our last few bits of the common room chat, there are a few little news items that I thought were worth mentioning. The first thing that I do want to let you guys know is that the Harry Potter store in New York is going to be closed for a couple days for routine maintenance. They put out an Instagram story letting us know that they are going to be closed from January 24th to January 27th. So if you are planning a vacation around that time and you're wanting to visit the Harry Potter store, I just wanted to let you know, in case that was on your list to do, that they will not be open on those 3 days. Now, moving over to Universal Studios in Orlando, Florida, I did want to give you guys just a little update. They did post on their Instagram that starting on January 3rd through at least February 28th of 2022, Hagrid's Motorbike Adventure is no longer going to be opening during early admission hours. So just a small piece of information. They're not closing the ride down at all. They're just not allowing you that extra hour at the very beginning whenever the park's open. And then, just in case anyone didn't know, the 2022 Collector's Edition wand from Universal is available for purchase now. So if you collect them, like I do, make sure to get one before they sell out. I'm definitely going to have to take a look on the website. They are available online, I believe. And because I'm not sure when I'm going to get back to Universal, I'll probably be buying it that way. And then for our last bit of news for this episode, now, this is news on a small shop, so I'm not sure if everyone knows, but there is a wand maker, and their shop is called Brown and Lobbin. And I just wanted to give you guys an update, because he makes fantastic wands. I'm sure a lot of people here know of Cherry Wallace, and he has made her a couple different wands, and they're always just so beautiful, And I personally have been looking at them for a while. And they used to do a custom wand. So they'll send you a form and you fill it out and he makes you a wand, you know, according to you. So basically the wand is choosing the wizard. And they stopped doing custom wand orders at the end of last year. I was lucky enough to see with 6 hours left that he was not doing them anymore. So I ordered one. So keep an eye out for that video. Although it can take 8 to 12 months for you to get your wand. But they're beautiful and I'm here for waiting for it. But I just wanted to update you guys that he is no longer doing custom wands. He's still going to be making wands. So if you enjoy his work, definitely keep an eye out for his Etsy because he's still going to be making them. He's just no longer doing custom wands. So that's the last of our news for this week. But I do want to give a small shop shout out to The Common Room Shop. The Common Room Shop is a shop that I follow on Instagram, and I wanted to give them a shout out because the shirt that I am wearing today is actually from them, and I thought it was the perfect shirt for my very first episode of The Common Room Chat. So let me stand up and show you this shirt because I think it's incredible. So you can see this shirt has like a picture window view of the Slytherin Common Room. You guys, that's where we are right now. We're in the Slytherin Common Room, and I thought the design was just incredible. You can see that you have the three stars from the American books, and you just have this whole Slytherin aura and vibe going on the common room. And then if you look at the very bottom here, you can see where it says the common room. So I had to show you and give them a shout out. They have a lot of amazing items, so definitely take a look at them. See if you can find any Harry Potter clothing that you might want. And they don't just have Slytherin common room shirts. You can also get your own house. So each one is different and you can get all four houses, Slytherin, Gryffindor, Hufflepuff, and Ravenclaw. All right, guys. So that was all of the news for our first episode of The Common Room Chat. I hope that all the information I gave you was helpful and is going to help keep you updated on all of the magical happenings in the wizarding world. I would love to know what you guys thought of the video. Leave a comment and let me know what kind of news you would like to stay updated on. I plan on keeping everyone updated on subscription boxes and anything major that I see coming through the week. But if you have any specifics, definitely let me know because I would love to incorporate all kinds of different events and different information from the Wizarding World and anything that you guys would love to stay updated on. As always, thank you for watching. If you would like to see more videos related to Harry Potter and the Wizarding World, feel free to like this video and subscribe to my channel. And I hope to see you next time in the common room.